Today, we are going to add a carousel to our projects listing, and after that, start our newsletter module. But hey, if you are new to this channel, I'm Peter, and I upload 1 to 3 videos weekly about web development. If that sounds interesting to you, don't forget to subscribe. Okay, so like I said in our intro, today we should first display a carousel for our images. And actually display the project in a nicer way. Of course, we are not doing design here, but yeah, it to be at least something nicer than what we have right now. And after that, we should start our newsletter module, which will basically be a module where clients or users or can subscribe to our list, and we will send the newsletter weekly or monthly, or we'll decide this later. Of course, we won't finish it today because it is a pretty big module, but it's a place to start. So let's do that today. Okay, so let's start by going to bootstrap.com. So bootstrap.com and get bootstrap.com actually. Okay, and here let's type on search bar carousel, because that's what we need. A way to display the images, so something like this. With a slider basically. So let's copy this example and let's say that we have our projects, and for each of our projects, my bad, okay, we have carousel example controls. We just have not sure if this ID means anything. Okay, carousel slide, data ride carousel. We have our images that doesn't have anything, just some source that we probably don't have. So let's see, hit plus. Oh, so dummy. It's just okay. So for each carousel item. That's pretty good. Okay, let's delete that and leave only one image. And let's say that this carousel item, of course, doesn't have active, only the first one. So let's remove it first. And let's say that, my bad, let's say that for each. And let's send the for each. Okay. And here, let's say that project images. I'm not sure if we have this relation, but we'll check it out later. So project images as image. Okay. And let's say that the source. It should be image, actually asset of image src. And the project name doesn't matter. Carousel example controls, I see. So that's why this it was with an ID. Well, let's first see what happens. Actually, let's put the carousel. Let's copy this ID and put it on again on the ID side of this. And let's say that we have, okay, let's check out if something happens. Probably not, because we have to initialize this carousel. But let's first run our server. So in a terminal, PHP artisan serve, going to localhost 8000 instead of this. Actually, let's leave this open. So going to localhost 8000 and going to / portfolio. We have this. Let's say that we don't have any images. Let's refresh this and okay, not sure what happened. Oh, I know what. It's okay. We have the same image for this for multiple projects, but we deleted an image from a project that had the same image, and right now it's 404. This is an issue, but we don't actually need to treat it. So, I mean, for our projects, we won't have images with I don't want to upload the same image, so it's okay to have the same name and replace it. Okay. So let's do something else. Since we have this, we ask for the images, but it won't happen anything because we need to initialize this carousel. So let's do some JS. I think it was something like that. So let's say that section. Scripts and section document dot ready function and here let's say that we have our carousel. So let's say that all carousels, it's a type of, sorry, that carousel. I mean, initialize it. Let's go to our page in hard reload, and nothing happens, and I wonder why. So we have our images. Let's refresh this. Probably we have the same ID for each of them. So this might be a problem. So let's test out by putting here, let's say the project ID. So anywhere we have this, so project ID. And let's say that we copy this and put it everywhere. Okay, I'm not sure if this needs to be anywhere else, and it's not. Okay, that wasn't. Okay, so here it is a pretty small option, but yeah, we need to add our active to some slide. So let's do that. Otherwise, it won't be visible. So we have our slider right now, and doesn't seem to work though because they are all active. So let's say that add, because we need to do that. So add if and if it's pretty ugly, but yeah, loop. It's if it's first in loop. Display the active. Okay. Is this working right now? And we finally have a slider. Of course, what I want to do is to check if file exists. So we could do something like a PHP check. So add this if file exists with the PHP helper. Something like off asset image src and let's send this if so and if so doing that it will ensure that public path so public path dot image src and I think this should be again asset of image src. Unfortunately, we can't trust it will be a useless variable. And again, it's not working because we might need to add a slash after this. Okay, so doing that, but we didn't ensure anything because right now we still have some that doesn't have any images or something like that. Oh, and if we should add this carousel only if the project has images. So let's do if how we do that. If count of project images. And let's end this. So end if. So we have our projects, but with the one that has images with carousels, and that's pretty cool. What? But we have a problem here because we forgot to how it is spelled. Because we forgot to load these images. Right now we have an n plus one query problems. For each project, it will fetch the images from database, so we'll need to eager load them with parameters. So let's go to projects controller, public projects controller, and here actually on our get all projects run method, so going to get all projects action, we need to change this to with images, and let's say get. So right now nothing happens, but it makes a less query count, of course, because still has to fetch the images from that database, but it makes like two queries instead of one query for the projects, and after that for each project query the images, which will be a bad practice. So going to our again to our projects blade.blade.php. Here, since we have our carousel, we have our project. Not sure what we should do. Maybe title align it center. So I think we could do this to remove the divs. And let's say class equals text center. And let's say that we have a for each project, of course the title should be before, so let's put the title here, and let's say that it has a empty of 3 and MB of 3. Okay, and I think we could have used some background or sort of, so we could for the design purposes of our page. Of course we are not getting into design right now, so what I want to do this, all of this is actually just temporary until we get to the design part of this project, which will be, I'm not sure, after a few videos more. We still have like two features to implement, so let's do that. What I want to do right now is to display actually the tags too. So we should have go to our action and load the tags. And let's go to project.php because I'm not sure. Okay, we have our relation of tags. So we should go to project.blade.php and display the tags too. For example, let's say that we would just display the tags in a div. Let's say that we have our project description here. So project description. Let's say that details or something like that. And after that, under that, we should have the tags. So let's go with the class, how it is called, project tags or sort of, I'm not sure. So let's say that for each we have a tag, actually project tags as tag. You see the tag name. It's here. And maybe a div for each of one of these. So let's do that. So we have our tags. That's alright, a bit messy. And let's say that this carousel, because I don't like it, I want to create a row for it. So let's say that we have our container and text white, and for each project we have a div, and I want to put it something like an images. Let's say that we have a row that has call md6 or two divs. So we will move the carousel, actually with the count images we need to do that. So let's say that we move this here, and here let's say that we have our details. Not sure if I made a mistake here, we'll check it out later. I mean right now. Okay, so right now we have our project displayed. Let's make a background for that. Actually, does Bootstrap have any pills? Oh, it has pill pages. So let's say that these tags are actually success instead of that div. So let's say that here, my bad. Okay, let's say that this okay. Let's refresh the page. Oh, this looks pretty cool, right? So we have our tags with the description and a carousel for our images and the projects without description. Probably we'll have on every project an image, but yeah, right now it's like that. So let's do it like that. Good, so we have this. It's a bit messy here, I'll think about it sometimes later maybe. We have our project run. Let's say that we have maybe a background for this, because I don't like it without background. So let's say that our project div, which we don't have, so this could be like the text white, and we could move this actually a little bit up, and we could just take a div and put it here. And right now nothing happens, but if we go to this text white div, which we don't really care to be anymore, so we could have background light or something like that. So it's white, which I don't like, but yeah, it could be dark. Okay, it has a dark class, so BG dark. Oh, and this looks pretty nice already. I really like this. Good. I actually will use this color to put it for our post cards too, but not right now. Okay, so that's what I wanted to do for the projects today. Let's commit our changes. And after that, okay, let's commit our changes. And after that, what? Okay. Public projects controller. We have our feature right now ready. So let's say that we have add simple public projects portfolio, actually the projects display. Let's commit our changes. And since, like I said, on our let's say going to home and actually slash portfolio, sorry. Oh, by the way, this error We couldn't use the project's route because I'm not sure if you figured it out or not. We have our projects folder in public, if you remember where we store our images. That means we can't use the route because first it will check the public folder, which is pretty bad. So, but we have our portfolio, which sounds a little bit more professional, let's say. So doing that, this looks nice anyway. This looks pretty nice. So we have our project. I really like this. Let's say that on our posts, I'm going to a single post page here on our sidebar, we will have a newsletter, let's say subscribe form. So what I want to do is actually to create a today, just to create the migration and the model for subscribers, actually subscriber model, and maybe create the controller file. And after that, we will actually go and develop the actual feature of it. So let's do that. Opening a terminal. Let's see that PHP artisan make migration. Create subscribers table. This is pretty simple. PHP artisan make model subscriber and PHP artisan make model, actually make controller subscribers controllers. So subscribers controller, sorry. Of course, we could use just one, let's say, command. But I want you to see all the commands and learn it, because the general one, it's actually a lot harder to keep in mind, and it didn't take us that much time anyway. So let's go to the migration. So subscribers migration, actually, yeah, and here. We have our create subscribers, big increments, which is not really okay, but we could use big increments here on this case and on the post, but the project shouldn't have this. Anyway, I see that table have a name, actually a string. My bad, table string. It should be a name. And let's copy this. Could be just an email, and we should have it as unique. Okay, so we have our string email, unique name, we have our timestamps, which is alright, and let's say that it is actually boolean, because I want to see if it is subscribed or active. I'm not sure. Subscribed. Or it's okay, subscribed. Which is the default of true. Because I don't want to specify if this subscribed thing. So yeah. This let's go to, actually before doing that, let's go to the subscriber, and I will just explain what I want to do on the next episode basically. So let's say that we have our private table equals subscribers, even though we follow the convention, and this eloquent model will know what table it has, but it's pretty good and a good practice to especially declare it. But anyway, let's talk about our newsletter feature. What I want to implement here, it is to have on our admin side our listing with a filter, because we don't have any filters right now implemented, even not even the searches one, because we don't really need it. But here we need it because it will get a lot bigger, maybe, hopefully, I'm not sure. And we should filter by the subscribed users and not subscribed. I want to keep the emails, even though I won't do anything if they are not subscribed. But yeah, you know what I mean. So we should see the subscribed or not subscribed. And if they ever want to subscribe again, we'll just change to subscribe. That's okay. Or we could just drop it. I'm not sure, but anyway, let's say active. And on our sidebar, we won't have any CRUD here, just to check the details in a table, and that's all. We won't delete it. We won't unsubscribe users only if they want to do that. And on the sidebar of a post, maybe on the home page or any page, we want to put that blade file, import component, whatever. The user will have the option to put his name and the email and submit to subscribe. After that, we will make a cron to actually check if we posted anything on the last week or month, not sure, and send the email to the users that are subscribed and still subscribed actually, and send them the emails or create the jobs for it. We will get into a lot more complex features or stuff, I'm not sure. But thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this kind of videos, please subscribe, leave a like, comment if you want it, and let's see each other on the next one.